Today is Palm Sunday.
今天是中之主日。
The beginning of the Holy Week.
就是圣周的开始。
And the start of Jesus' journey into to Calvary.
也是耶稣走向独炉地的开始。
And this morning we will meditate on the topic of celebrate the king.
今天我们就要默想，我们要来庆贺君王。
We will meditate on Mark chapter 11.
我们默想的经文取自马可福音十一章。
Before that, let us come to the Lord in prayer.
在之前，让我们先低头祷告。
Father Lord, we want to honor you this morning. Jesus, you be lifted up high among the nations.Today, you fix our eyes on you and you alone. Let our eyes and our hearts not be distracted by the things of the world. But Lord, let our eyes be fixed and gaze upon your loving kindness, your grace, and your mercy upon our life. That Lord, turn our eyes to you and fix our hearts on you alone. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. So as we meditate on Mark 11, we will start by listening and watching a short video clip narrating Mark chapter 11, verses 1 to 11. So this morning we have some young ones who are joining us. So let's welcome the little ones in our midst as well.
当我们今天默想马可福音十一章，先让我们来看看一个短短的动画片，就讲解了马可福音十一章一到十一节。我们也特别欢迎今天的那些孩童与我们一起在这里敬拜。
It was time to celebrate Passover, a special time to remember how God had freed his people from slavery in Egypt. Many Israelites had traveled to Jerusalem to celebrate God's amazing rescue. Jesus and his disciples were among the people who traveled to Jerusalem. When they neared Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples ahead into a village. As soon as you enter the village, Jesus told them, you will find a young donkey tied there.No one has ever sat on it. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone says to you, why are you doing this? Say, the Lord needs it. The disciples did as Jesus asked. As they untied the donkey, its owners asked why. The Lord needs it, they said. Then they brought the donkey to Jesus, threw their robes onto the donkey, and helped Jesus get onto it.People spread their robes along the road for Jesus, and others spread palm branches cut from the fields. The whole crowd praised God with a loud voice for all the miracles they had seen. Hosanna, they said. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven. The word Hosanna means save now. The people welcomed Jesus as their promised king. They hoped.He would save them from the Romans.
Amen. Hosanna means save now. The Lord saves.
Hosanna 的意思就是求神拯救。
This morning when you come into the Karukma house, I'm not sure whether you stop by to look at the pictures, the painting that are done by our youth.
今天早上你进来会堂的时候，不晓得你没有停下来欣赏一下，我们青少年那个画的图画。
So it is a story or a recap of what happened on the Passion Week.
这个图画就记载了在这个圣周里面发生的事情。
And this morning, even as you come in to the church, to the Karukma House, you are, I believe all of you are given a palm cross.
今天早上你们到宣恩楼教会的时候，我相信你们都拿到一个棕叶做的十字架。
Can you take out your palm crosses?
可以拿起你的十字架吗
？Shall we replay the scene of Jesus entering Jerusalem?
好不好？我们来重演当初耶稣进入耶路撒冷的场景。
We don't have palm branches this morning. Then we will wave the palm leaves, the palm crosses instead.
因为我们没有棕枝，所以我们就来挥动这一个棕叶做的十字架。
So as we celebrate Palm Sunday, the palm leaves made into a shape of a cross reminds us that Jesus had come and he had completed, fulfilled the mission on the cross.
在今天我们庆祝中之主日，我们拿着这个中野座的十字架，是因为我们要纪念耶稣已经降临，而且在十字架上已经完成了他的使命。
So later on, let's wave the palm crosses together and herald the coming of our King.
那么等一下就让我们挥动这个十字架，然后就预示我们君王的降临。
Let's imagine Jesus coming through the hallway and making his procession into this hall, into this church.
那么我们就想象耶稣现在穿过走廊走进会堂来。
Just like he's entering into Jerusalem.
就像他要进耶路撒冷。
And this morning as we worship, we want to welcome the King of Kings into our midst.
那么今天早上我们在这里崇拜，我们也要欢迎我们君王来我们的崇拜。
So before that, let us practice a bit. Let's
shout together. 一开始先让我们来学习。
Hosanna, 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 three times.
一起喊三声的何善呐。
Okay, one, two, three, ready? Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Yeah. Wow, Ernest, wonderful. Okay, now we do it the proper one according to the verses.
然后我们就看这个经文跟着念。
But we also repeat Hosanna three times.
何善呐三次。
Okay, together, one, two, go. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest heaven. Amen. Hosanna, Jesus saves, our Lord saves.
Hosanna, 我们的主耶稣会拯救。
So as we listen to the narration just now, it tells us that it is an occasion of Passover.
根据我们刚才在前面所听到的，当时呢就是逾越节。
So it's an occasion that the Jews would travel to Jerusalem to celebrate God's rescue, how the Lord had rescued their ancestors, freed them from slavery and delivered them from Egypt in the past.
那么犹太人就会去耶路撒冷，是因为他们要纪念神在过去的拯救工作，如何拯救他们的祖先，摆脱了奴役，然后从埃及被拯救出来。
So whenever Passover is celebrated, they remember that God saved.
所以每一次当他们庆祝逾越节的时候，他们都会纪念上帝拯救他们。
And at the same time, they also wait for the fulfillment of Zechariah's prophecy, on the coming king who will save them. And this prophecy was given more than 500 years ago.
同时他们也期待着撒加利亚所说的预言，是在500多年前说的预言，关于一个君王的降临。
And Zechariah chapter 9 verse 9 to 10 says,
那么撒加利亚书九章十节到十一节到十节说，
Rejoice greatly, daughter Zion, shout, daughter Jerusalem, see, your king comes to you, righteous and victorious, lowly and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. I will take away the chariots from Ephraim and the war horses from Jerusalem, and a battle bow will be broken. He will proclaim peace to the nations. His rule will extend from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth.
撒加利亚九章九到十节说，锡安的民啊，应当大大喜乐，耶路撒冷的民啊，应当欢呼，看啊，你的王来到你这里，他是公义的，并且施行拯救，谦谦和和地骑着驴，就是骑着驴的驹子。我必除灭以法莲的战车和耶路撒冷的战马，征战的弓也必除灭。他必向列国讲和平，他的权柄必从这海管到那海，从大河管到地极。
So this prophecy of Zechariah tells them that a future king will come riding on a donkey.
撒加利亚的这个预言就是说，他们的将来的君王会到，会骑着驴驹子来。
He will have victory over their enemies.
他会战胜他们的敌人。
So to the Jews during Jesus' time, their enemies are the Romans.
所以在当时耶稣的背景，他们的敌人就是罗马帝国。
And it also says that the battle bow will be broken, meaning that there will be an end to all wars.
他也说着战弓将会折断，就是意味着所有的战争都会结束。
And the new king will bring peace to the nations. He will rule and to the ends of the earth.
这个新王将给万国 国带来和平，他将统治到地极。
And this is the prophetic message that is given about the coming king.
这是
that he will ride on a donkey.
这是一个预言，关于这个君王将会到来，他会骑着驴驹子。
And so the people waited.
所以人民都在等待。
For 3 years, we see that Jesus went around teaching, healing, raising the dead, performing miracles.
在三年，耶稣都四处去在教导、治病，还有使人复活以及行神迹。
And there were multiple questions asked about his identity.
人们就有对他的身份就提出了很多问题。
Is he the one? Is he the prophet? Is he the promised Messiah?
他是那一位吗？他是先知吗？他是应许的弥赛亚吗？
People were curious to find out because they see him doing all this supernatural work among them.
人们对他行的这些超自然的神迹都很好奇，要知道他是谁。
But Jesus never gave them any answer until now.
但是耶稣从来都没有给他们答案，一直到现在。
So when the people saw Jesus coming into Jerusalem riding on a donkey, everything fitted the description of the prophecy.
因此当人们看着耶稣骑着卑微的驴驹子进入耶路撒冷的时候，一切都符合了这个预言的描述。
This is the sign. He is the one. Jesus is the one.
这就是一个证照，说耶稣就是他了。
He's the one who will come to end all wars, and he's the one who will come to give peace on earth.
他会来结束所有的战争，然后为世界带来和平。
He will establish a new kingdom among the Israels.
他会在以色列人当中兴起一个新的国度。
It means that they will no longer need to live under the Roman Empire's rule.
这样子，他们就不必生活在罗马帝国的统治之下。
So when the people saw Jesus on a coming to Jerusalem on a donkey, they were overjoyed.
所以当人民看到 耶稣骑着驴驹子进入 耶路撒冷，他们真的是非常的欣喜。
They rejoice because their king is finally here. So immediately they cut down palm branches, lay down their clothes on the floor, on the ground, and herald and welcome their new king.
他们非常的欣喜，知道他们的君王到来了，他们就立刻砍下棕枝，在地上铺他们 的衣服，然后欢迎他们新的君王。
And they shouted, Hosanna, Hosanna.
然后高呼，何善哪，何善哪。
So in this, on this Palm Sunday, the start of the Holy Week.
在这个棕枝主日是圣周的开始。
As we join the nation in celebrating our king.
当我们和万国一同庆贺我们的君王。
So I want to ask four questions. Four what questions?
我就要问你们四个什么或怎样的问题。
What kind of king are we celebrating?
我们庆贺的是一位怎样的君王？
What twisted the events from celebration to condemnation, crucifixion.
是什么让这个庆典演变成定罪事件的呢？
And what kind of king is Jesus?
耶稣是一位怎样的君王？
What can we do this week to glorify Jesus our king?
在这一个星期，我们可以做些什么来荣耀我们的耶稣君王？
So what kind of king are we celebrating?
那么我们庆贺的是一位怎样的君王呢？
When we see that when the people cheered and celebrated, they all had some kind of expectation on this new king.
所以当人们欢呼庆贺的时候，他们对这一位新的君王就有一些期待，一些期望。
What were they expecting?
他们期望的是什么呢？
The people wanted an earthly political kingdom.
人们想要一个世俗的政治王国。
But God wants to give them want to give people, every one of us, an eternal spiritual kingdom.
但是神要给我们每一个人一个永恒的属灵国度。
We know that for a long time, because of the rebellious heart of the Jews, the Israelites, they had lost their promised land, and they were in exile and were taken captives.
长久以来，由于犹太人的悖逆的心，所以他们就失去了应许之地，被流放，也被俘虏了。
Eventually, when they were allowed to return to their homeland to rebuild their homes, but they're still under the rule of a foreign king.
当他们最后获准能够回到故土，重建他们家园的时候，他们发现依然是在异国国王的统治之下。
So these people waited for the day where their promised king will come. come, someone like King David, a king of their very own.
所以人们就等待着他们应许的君王来到，一个像大卫王那样的人。
Someone who's going to rule and rule over the nation Israel.
是他们自己的王，一个统治他们自己国家的国王。
So when Jesus came, they thought that he is the one, the new political king that they are going to have.
所以当耶稣来了，他们就认为是他了，他们新的国王，一个政治的国王。
However, what they did not expect was that God had a different kind of kingdom in mind.
但是他们不晓得的是，在神的心里，他想的是另一种国度。
Not a temporary kingdom where the kings will be changed again and again over time.
不是一个王国呢，这个国王会随着时间的改变而在变换。
But an eternal and lasting spiritual kingdom.
而是一个永恒持久的属灵国度。
He wants to build a nation that is holy and set apart for him.
他要兴起一个圣洁的国度，是为他而分别为圣的。
He wants a nation that will be faithful and love their king, their only, the king of kings alone.
因为他要的是一个忠心爱这个万王之王的一个国度。
So we see that on Sunday they were cheering and cheering, but on Friday we see a different event happening.
所以我们就看到在那一天，他们就看星期天，他们就看到人们都在庆贺欢呼，但是
星期五
啊，他们在庆贺欢呼。
So what twisted the event from a celebration to a condemnation?
所以是什么事情让整件事情转变成从一个庆典变成一个定罪的事件呢？
What exactly happened that turned the Hosanna to crucify him?
是什么让这个 Hosanna 和善纳变成是把他钉在十字架上？
I can only see that because there are some unmet expectations.
我可以想到的就是因为他们的期望没有达到。
Expectations not met will lead to disappointment, anger, frustrations, and all kinds of negative feelings.
如果期望没有达到的话，就会令人很失望，也有愤怒、沮丧，也带来其他负面的情绪。
These people had expected Jesus to be some kind of king.
因为这些人是期望耶稣是一个君王。
But it turns out that he's not what they had expected.
但是到最后却发现他并不是他们所期望的。
So take for example in our everyday life, for example, I expect my husband to be the leader of the house because God made all men the head of the family.
就像在我们日常生活里，譬如说，我希望我的丈夫是家庭的领导者，因为神是让男人成为一家之主。
But when the man did not rise up to the expectation, not able to lead, unable to make decisions for the family.
但是当这个男人就没有达到期望，没有领导能力，也不能为家庭做主。
What the wife expected and what happened in reality didn't match.
所以这个妻子的期望和现实是不一致的。
And when the emotion is not processed well, anger, disappointment, frustration, eventually criticisms will come in and the marriage relationship will be affected.
那么当这个情绪没有得到很好的处理的话，他就会开始愤怒、失望、沮丧，然后批评就进来了，那么这就会影响了他们的婚姻关系。
So usually what started off well as a loving marriage relationship because of unmet expectation, the relationship is broken.
所以一开始是一个很有爱的一个婚姻关系，就是因为期望落空了，所以就整个关系就破裂了。
So when the people saw Jesus coming in, they had high hope on Jesus.
所以当这些人看到耶稣进来了，他们对他有很高的期望。
They expected Jesus to be the political king, but God wanted him to lead a different kind of kingdom.
他们希望这个耶稣是一个他们世俗的一个政治国王，但是神要给他们的是一个不同的国王，一个不同的君王国度。
Their expectations and God's plan did not meet.
他们的期望和神的计划是不一致的。
Therefore, they became angry. They have all kinds of negative thoughts, and eventually they plotted his crucifixion.
所以他们就开始就很愤怒，还有很多负面的情绪。到最后呢，他们就要密谋要杀害耶稣。
So let us go through some of the events that happened during the Holy Week and see at what point what event twisted the situation.
让我们来看看这个圣周一直全部发生的事件，让我们能够看到到底是什么事情让整个事件演变成转成到最后变成他要把耶稣钉在十字架上。
So on Sunday it was the triumphant entry.
星期天就是耶稣光荣的进圣城。
But what happened after the cheering and the welcoming?
但是在欢呼和这个欢迎之后发生了什么事情呢？
Where did Jesus go? What did he do?
耶稣去了哪里做了什么？
He did not ride his donkey to the royal palace. He did not lead an army to take over from the Romans as the new king.
他没有骑着驴子去王宫，也没有率领军队从罗马人的手中拿过这个新王的宝座。
Instead, he went to check out the temple courts.
而是去查看圣殿。
Mark 11:11 tells us that he went to the temple court. He stood there, looked around, and then because it was late, he did not do anything. And then he left Jerusalem and go back to Bethany to rest.
马可福音十一章十一节就说他去了耶路撒冷，去了圣殿，然后到处看看，没有什么事情。然后那是天色已晚，他就去了伯大尼。
So hooray, hooray, hosanna, hosanna! When the celebration is over, party ended. Jesus just left Jerusalem.
那么当初的一直在喊和善呐，和善呐。到但是当庆祝和聚会结束之后呢，耶稣就离开了耶路撒冷。
It's just like the celebration never happened.
就好像整个庆典没有发生似的。
And the next day come Monday.
第二天就星期一。
Jesus again made his way back into Jerusalem.
耶稣就再次的回到耶路撒冷。
And on his way, he was hungry and he saw a fig tree, full of leaves, meaning that the fig tree is very healthy.
在路上他很饿，就看见一棵无花果树，就叶子很茂盛，就代表着是很健康。
He went through, he go through the leaves and all those trying to look for fruit, but no fruit.
他就翻开叶子要找果实，但是没有果实。
So Jesus cursed the fig tree and said, "May no one ever eat fruit from you again."
于是呢，耶稣就诅咒这个无花果树，说从今以后永没有人吃你的果子。
Then Jesus continued his journey into Jerusalem.
之后，耶稣就继续前往去耶路撒冷。
He did not go to the royal palace to have his swearing-in ceremony.
他也没有去王宫去举行他的宣誓就职仪式。
Unlike our days, our political leaders who is being sworn into position after winning an election.
也不像在我们这个现今的时代，那些政治领袖在大选获胜之后呢，就会要去举行这个宣誓仪式。
So the people were curious and they were looking and observing this new king very closely.
所以那些人民就很好奇，他们就很仔细地观察这位新的君王。
What new system is he going to introduce or remove to change and make our lives better?
他会引入什么新的制度，或者是取消什么旧的制度，来改善我们的生活吗？
So they followed Jesus very closely to see what he is doing, what he's saying.
所以他们就非常仔细地观察耶稣的一言一行。
And then next, Jesus went into the temple court again.
接着耶稣就去了圣殿。
He went to check out his house, which is the reason why he came.
他的原因就是因为他要去看他的家。
So when he was at the temple courts, he saw the people selling and buying at the temple courts. His righteous anger fled.
那么当他看到人们在圣殿里做买卖的时候，他就发一怒了。
He overturned the table of the money changers and drove the people out.
他就推翻了兑换银钱之人的桌子，把他们赶了出去。
And then he said to them, "Is it not written, 'My house will be called a house of prayer for all nations,' but you have made it into a den of robbers?"
他就对他们说，经上不是记着说，我的殿必称为万国祷告的殿，但是你们却把它变成了贼窝了。
Imagine at this time when the chief priests and the teachers of the law saw this, what goes through their mind?
那你在想象，在当时那个祭司长和那个文士，在他们的眼中，你知道他们会怎么想吗？
It must have angered them, and they must be wondering, Jesus, aren't you supposed to take over the new government and run the country? What are you doing here in the temple?
他们一定会很生气，然后就说：“耶稣，你不是要接管新的政府，管理国家吗？你怎么来这里？来这里我们的敬拜场所
？”Why do you come and upset our place of worship?
你为什么来扰乱我们的敬拜场所呢
？And what gave you the right to condemn and accuse us for turning the temple into a den of robbers?
你凭什么来指责我们把圣殿变成了贼窝呀？
This is our territory. This is my ground. You should go and rule the nation, not come here to meddle with the religious matter.
这是我的领域，是我们的地盘。你应该去治理国家，而不是来干涉宗教事务。
And this made the event took a twist in the event of celebration to leading to what is going to happen.
这就是把这个整个庆典的事件转变成接下来要发生的。
So from welcoming and celebrating the new king to later on plotting and planning for his death.
从欢迎庆贺这个新的君王到密谋要杀害他。
What they had expected and hoped for in this King Jesus was not met, and they became angry, disappointed, and they started to have all this negative stirring going on within.
他们对这位耶稣君王的期望就落空了，所以他们就变得很愤怒、很失望，然后内心就开始了有很多负面的情绪。
Are we not like that sometimes?
我们有时不也是这样吗
？Sometimes in our prayer we say, "God, you are righteous and just God."
有时在我们的祷告中，我们说：“神啊，你是公义和公正的神。”
This political situation happening in our nation is not right. We cannot tolerate it. Would you do something and bring a change?
在我们的国家，我们的政治的这个局势发生了这样的情况是不对的，我们不能容忍。你可以来改变整个局势吗
？Years pass, people prayed. It seems like in our eyes, nothing happened.
然后多年过去了，人民也祷告了，但是在我们的眼中似乎没有看到有什么改变。
What we expected.God to do, it seems like He did not do. He was silent.
我们期望神要做的事情，他没有做。我们看到神似乎是沉默的。
And to some who, because of disappointment and angry with God, they turned the other side. They turned the other way and stopped worshiping God.
那么在这些有些人看到就开始感到很失望也很愤怒那么 就反过来然后最后就决定不要敬拜神
When our expectations were not met sometimes it can take us the total the opposite way
当我们的期望落空的时候呢事情可能就把我们带了相反的方向
So at the end of the Monday Jesus again left Jerusalem
在那么在星期一那一天过后就耶稣也就再去了耶路撒冷
离开
耶路撒冷
So Tuesday again he come back and into Jerusalem
那么在第二天他就回来耶路撒冷
And on his way the Jesus disciples realized that the fig tree has withered
那一天门徒就发现了这个无花果树就枯干了
And again, on this second day, Tuesday, Jesus did not do anything that seems like he's ruling the nation.
在这个星期二，耶稣就没有做什么事情，就好像他也没有去接管这个国家。
He continued to go to the temple to teach, and the people started to question his authority.
他就继续去圣殿教导，然后人们就开始质问他的权柄了。
On Sunday, he's the king.And on Tuesday, they questioned his authority.
星期天他是君王，但是星期二人们就开始质问他关于他的权柄。
And when the day ended on the evening of Tuesday, in the house of Simon the leper.
那么在这个星期二傍晚的时候，在这个有长大麻风的人西门的家里。
Mary came into the room where Jesus and his disciples were reclining.
那么玛丽就走进这个屋子，当耶稣和他的门徒在坐席。
And she broke open the bottle of the alabaster jar of perfume, a very expensive perfume.
她就打破装有昂贵的香膏的玉瓶。
And she used the perfume to anoint Jesus.
她以这个香膏来膏耶稣。
And this upset many people again.
这就让在场的很多人不开心了。
They begin to calculate the cost of the perfume.
他们就开始计算这个昂贵的香膏的价钱。
Is it worth it to do what you are doing?
他说：“你这样做值得吗
And but Jesus said, just leave this woman alone.
耶稣就说你不要管这个女人。
So when all this happened, even his very own disciple, Judas began to have doubts.
就 这一切事情的发生，令到他的门徒之一，也就是犹大，也开始有产生疑问了。
Judas, one of his very own disciples, someone who lived, who heard him, who traveled with him, who ministered with him for 3 years, also did not start to question Jesus.
他的门徒之一这个犹大与耶稣一起生活了三年，和他旅行，也听过他的道，也一起服侍其他的人，他也开始有疑问了。
At this point, he must have thought, maybe I have followed the wrong master.
在这一个时刻，他可能在想，我一定是跟错了主。
And he decided to betray Jesus in exchange for money.
所以他就决定要出卖耶稣来换取金钱。
Wednesday come.
星期三到了。
And the leaders begin to plot against Jesus and to wait for the opportunity to capture him.
这些领袖们呢，就开始密谋要杀害耶稣，然后就等着时机要去捉他。
So the rest of the events follows Thursday, Monday Thursday, the breaking of bread, the washing of the feet, and Friday comes is the rest.And the crucifixion.
那么接下来星期四就是星期四晚，就是主力圣餐夜，然后为门徒洗脚等等。星期五，就他被捕，然后受审。
So from one event,
然后是被钉十字架。
Yeah. So from one event to leading to another, what they had expected was shattered.
然后他们所期望的就全部是破碎了。
Their hopes have gone.The other way around.
他们的盼望也落空了。
So they must have thought Jesus is not the one. He must be the wrong king that we have cheered for.
所以他们可能就想，我们当初欢呼的这个君王，是错误的。
So they turn later on this celebration turned into a crucifixion.
所以这个庆典呢，到最后就转变成为把他钉在十字架上。
So when we this morning as we meditate on celebrate the King, what kind of King is Jesus?
那么今天早上当我们默想，我们要庆贺这君王，那耶稣是怎样的一位君王呢？
In Zechariah chapter 9, it tells us that he is the King that is the promised one.
那么在撒加利亚九章，他就说这一位君王是应许的。
And he's the triumphant King.
他是得胜的君王。
He has already won the battle, and he comes to reestablish what it should be.
他已经战胜了，那么他来到是为了重建本该有的一切。
Because of God's covenant, in Zechariah chapter 9, one of the verses says that, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will free your prisoners.From the waterless pit.
就撒加利亚九章就说，因为是神立的约，他说我以你立约的血将你中间被掳的而囚的从无水的坑中释放出来。
The Lord made a covenant with his people to be their God forever.
那么神就与人民立约，成为他们永恒的王。
Even all these years pass, we see how the people has been rebellious. They haveTurn away from God, but God was faithful to the end.
虽然我们看到在经过一段时间，这些人都有悖逆的心，也离弃了神，但是神是一直仍然是信实的。
He promised that he will send them a king, and he did.
他应许他们，他会给他们一位君王，他真的是做到了。
He promised to give them a savior, and he did.
他说他会给他们一位救主，他也做到了。
So as we celebrate Jesus, the triumphant King, we celebrate a covenant-keeping God who never fails us in His promise.
当我们庆贺这一位得胜的君王，我们也庆贺的是一位守约的神，他的应许从不落空。
And we celebrate Jesus, the righteous King.
我们也庆贺耶稣，他是公义的君王。
After Jesus' entry into Jerusalem, in the eyes of the people, it seems that he did not do anything to change the kingdom.
当耶稣光荣进入圣城之后，在人们的眼中，他没有做什么要去改变当时的那个王国。
But Jesus has definitely started his kingdom ministry.
其实呢，耶稣是已经开始了他神国度的事工。
He began by reordering his spiritual and heavenly kingdom.
他就重新安排了他属灵和属天的国度。
We see that Monday and Tuesday, the cleansing of the temple is sandwiched between the two parts account of the fig tree.
在星期一和星期二，我们就看到洁净圣殿这件事件是被夹在两个无花果树的记载中间。
The fig tree figuratively represents Israel, God's people.
这个无花果比喻的是以色列，神的子民。
The curse on the fig tree is a pronouncement of judgment that will come upon God's people when they do not bear fruit.
对无花果树的咒诅呢，是对神子民的审判，因为他们没有结果子。
And when the fig tree really died, it represents God's authority and His word.
那么当无花果树枯萎的时候，这就代表了神的话语啊，
权威啊。
全灭了，
And the total destruction will come upon those who does not bear fruit.
那么这些没有结果子的人就遭到了彻底的毁灭。
And we know that in the Word of God, we are always reminded that at the last days, when our Christ, our Jesus comes again, and He will also come to judge, and the judgment will begin from the house of God.
我们知道在末世的时候耶稣会再来审判他先审判就是从他神的家先开始
And that is why when we read the book of Revelation it begins with the letters to the seven churches
那么我们读启示录的时候他一开始就是七封写给七个教会的信
It's a letter to remind them or to warn themYou have lost your first love. You have become lukewarm.
那个信是要警告他们说，你们已经把起初的爱心，离弃了，你们变得是冷淡的。
You love the world now more than you love me.
你们爱世界爱过多过爱我。
Repent and return to me before the final judgment comes.
所以你们要悔改，要归向我，在那个最后的审判还没有来之前。
So God is sending out messages to wake up the church.
所以那个神就给教会这些警告
to repent and to return to.
要他们苏醒，然后要悔改，然后归向神。
And for the Israelites, we know that again and again, the Lord is sending messages to warn them to return to Him.
我们知道，对于这些以色列人，神就一直给他们信息，要警告他们。
So when the first thing Jesus did was to come into the house to clear the temple.
所以耶稣做的第一件事就是来到圣殿来洁净神的家。
He cleared the temple courts and said that this is going to be my house of prayer.
他就洁净圣殿，就说这个是我这个是祷告的殿。
And this is in reference to Isaiah 56 verses 3 to 7.
这是我们可以看以赛亚书56章3到7节。
And it says that let no foreigners who is bound to the Lord say, the Lord will surely exclude me from his people.
他说与耶和华联合的外邦人不要说耶和华必定将我从他民中分别出来。
And let no eunuch complain, I am only a dry tree, for this is what the Lord says.
他也说不要那个太监也不要说我是枯树。
To the eunuch who keep my Sabbath,Who choose what pleases me and hold fast to my covenant, to them I will give within my temple and its wall a memorial and a name better than sons and daughters.
他说那些谨守我的安息日，拣选我所喜悦的事，持守我约的太监，我必使他们在我殿中，在我墙内有纪念，有名号，比有儿女的更美。我必赐他们永远的名，不能剪除。
Yeah, I will give them an everlasting name that will endure forever.
我必赐他们永远的名，不能剪除。
And foreigners who bind themselves to the Lord to minister Him, to love the name of the Lord, and to be His servants, all who keep the Sabbath without desecrating it, and who hold fast to my covenant, this I will bring to my holy mountain and give them joy in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be accepted on my altar.For my house will be called a house of prayer for all nations.
还有那些与耶和华联合的外邦人，要侍奉他，要爱耶和华的名，要做他的仆人，就是反守安息日， 不干饭又持守他约的人，我必领他们到我的圣山，使他们在祷告我的殿中喜乐，他们的燔祭和平安祭在我坛上必蒙悦纳，因我的殿必称为万民祷告的殿。
So the temple court that Jesus came to clear is a place where the non-Jews worship.
所以耶稣来洁净这个圣殿的外院是非犹太人敬拜的地方。
So in the past, we used to think that, oh, maybe only the Jews are allowed to worship in the temple.
所以在过去我们可能想只是犹太人才能够进到圣殿内去敬拜。
But Isaiah tells us that even the foreigners, even the eunuchs, they are welcome if they come to worship God and to keep his Sabbath.
但是在以赛亚书我们就看到外邦人甚至太监都可以来到圣殿来敬拜，而且他们如果他们守他的安息日的话。
So that within the temple, there is a temple court, a place where they allow these non-Jews to come, to the Gentiles to come to worship God.
所以在这个圣殿的外院就有那一些非犹太人可以来到这个圣殿敬拜。
But the religious leaders have robbed the opportunities from these Gentiles by turning the place of worship to become a noisy, a smelly marketplace.And so the Gentiles will have no place to worship, even if they want to.
但是这个宗教领袖呢，就剥夺了非犹太人敬拜的机会，把非犹太人敬拜的地方变成了一个吵杂、臭气熏天的集市。那么这些外邦人即使要敬拜，也没有地方可以敬拜了。
So Jesus came to clear out the temple courts to reorder the kingdom government.
因此，耶稣来就清理来洁净这个圣殿，重新安排神国。
So he came to make rooms for the nations to come and worship the King of Kings.
他是为前来敬拜万王之王的万民腾出空间。
Jesus, the righteous King, did this so that we as a nation, we can come.And we can all come to worship him.
那么耶稣是公义的君王，他做这一切就是希望万民能够可以来到敬拜他。
So even as we worship Jesus, the righteous King, we want to celebrate a King who wants the nations to be saved.
所以当我们庆贺君王，我们是庆贺这一位希望万民得救的君王。
And finally, we want to worship Jesus, the sacrificial king.
最后我们要庆贺耶稣，因为他是一位牺牲的君王。
We celebrate a king who gave his all to us.
我们庆贺的是一位为我们献出一切的君王。
In a few days, we will once again journey with Christ as he bear the heavy cross and the burden of our sins and walk the lonely journey to Calvary.
再过几天呢，我们就会与耶稣与基督再次同行，他背负着沉重的十字架，我们的罪的重担，孤独的走向独楼地。
So in obedience and surrendering his life fully to God the Father,He took up the punishment of the world's sin upon himself.
他顺服地将自己的生命完全地交托于天父，然后自己来承担了世人罪的惩罚。
He came as a king, but a servant king, not to be served, but to serve.
他是以君王的身份到来，但是是仆人君王的身份，不是为了被服侍，而是要服侍人。
As we celebrate a king who gave his all to us, let us...Also learn total obedience as Jesus did.
当我们庆贺这一位为我们献出一切的君王时，让我们也效法基督，完全的顺服。
As Jesus surrendered himself to God, let us also surrender ourselves fully to Christ.
当耶稣他完完全全的降服于神，那我们也将自己完完全全的降服于神。
Our life does not belong to us, but God has given us life.
我们的生命不属于自己，而是神给我们生命。
So over the week, the crowd changed the Hosanna to crucifixion.
所以在这一个星期呢，从一个何善那变成了把它钉在十字架上。
So as believers, you and me today, how are we going to observe this Holy Week?
那么我们身为信徒，在这一个圣周，我们能够做些什么呢？
What can we do this week to continue to glorify Jesus our King?
那么在这个星期，我们能够做些什么来继续的荣耀我们的耶稣君王呢？
Will we also be like them? Today we shout Hosanna, and then tomorrow we say, God, I don't want your kingdom.
我们会不会像他们一样？这个星期我们说何塞纳，下一个星期我们就明天我们就说神啊，我们不要你的国度。
So in this over this week, let us do three things that we can that can help us to continue to worship and honor him as the king of our lives.
那么在这个星期有三件事我们可以做的，让我们能够继续的遵从和敬拜他，是我们的我们的君王。
So we look up with a heart of gratitude.
我们仰望有一个感恩的心。
We reach out and like Jesus make room for others.
我们向别人向他人伸出手，为他们腾出空间。
And we lay down just like Jesus surrendering himself.
我们把一切都放下，然后就像耶稣一样，我们降服于神。
So for a God who never forgets his people, who keeps his covenant even to the unfaithful ones, we look up with a heart of gratitude.
神从来不会忘记他的子民，即使是对不忠心的人，他依然守约，所以我们要怀着感恩的心来仰望他。
So we look up and we give thanks. We thank God. We give thanks. Every morning you wake up, you give thanks to Him for His unchanging love. Give thanks to God for reaching out to us.
那么我们的怀着感恩的心，仰望他，献上感恩，每一天都早上，当我们醒来，都感恩，感谢他亘古不变的爱，还有感谢他向我们伸出手。
For a righteous king who comes to judge, warning those who have fallen off,to repent and return.
为了这位公义的君王来到来审判，警告那些堕落的人要悔改，而且归向神。
Clearing the temple courts to make room for the Gentiles so that all nations can come to worship him.
他洁净圣殿，为外邦人腾出空间，让万民都能够来敬拜他。
So this week we also reach out to both the believers and the pre-believers.
所以这个星期呢，就让我们也伸出手，像信徒，也像未信徒，就我们向他们伸出手。
I'm not sure among you, do you have friends who are believers, but they have fallen away? It is time to reach out to them and come invite them to come home.
我不知道你们有没有朋友曾经是信徒，但是他们已经离开了神，那么就叫他们回家，带他们一起来敬拜。
Invite them this week to come and worship and meditate again the message of the cross.
那么邀请他们来敬拜，同时让叫他们与我们一起默想这一个周关于十字架的信息。
For the pre-believers, let us make room for them to come and worship our righteous King. Let us reach out to them.
那么我们也伸手向那一些伸出手，向那一些未信徒，让我们腾出空间，也让他们一起来与我们敬拜我们公义的君王。
So for a sacrificial King who laid down his life for us, this Holy Week, is there something that you can do to lay down, to surrender, to give up for God?
我们这一位为我们舍命的牺牲君王，那么看着他在这一周呢，我们有什么是可以放下，然后就是降服于神的吗？
And usually in the month of the Lent, we encourage people to fast.
那么通常在这个预苦期，我们都会鼓励弟兄姐妹们禁食。
Fast and pray, but this year it's been a bit difficult because it coincides with the Chinese New Year.
就是一起禁食祷告，但是今年可能就会比较困难，因为之前就是华人新年嘛。
Yeah, well, we want to fast, but we are still feasting.
我们要禁食，但是同时呢，又一起然后享用美食聚餐哈。
About this final week of the Holy Week, as we go through it, would you consider fasting a meal every day?
但是，在这一个最后的一个圣周，你有想过可以禁食一餐吗？就是不吃一餐吗
？Or fast from a social media or entertainment?
或者不用社交媒体，还有放弃娱乐。
So for some of us, maybe we spend 20 minutes or 2 hours a night before we sleep to scroll the screen. But how about turning that time into feasting on God's word?
我们有些人可能要花20分钟到一两个小时来划你手机玩手机。我们有没有想过就利用那一段时间来读神的话语
？So on this Holy Week, let us learn to seek first the kingdom of God.
那么让我们在这个圣周先来寻求神的国。
And all things will be added to us.
那么全部东西都会加在我们身上。
For Jesus said that when we try to alive, we will lose it. But when we lay it down for Him, we will be given life.
因为耶稣说，当我们要去赚取这个生命，我们就会失去。但是当我们把一切都放下，我们就得到了生命。
So we learn to look up, we reach out, and we lay down.
所以我们学习仰望，然后外展，也放下。
Let's pray.
让我们祷告。
Father, we want to thank you for your sacrificial love for all of us.That especially during this Passion Week, this Holy Week, we want to continue to meditate upon your love for us and for the nation. That Lord, that we pray that even as we read of your word, we pray that Lord, your word will continue to speak to us. Forgive us, Lord, if there are ways that we have not honored you as our King, as our Lord over our lives. Today we want to celebrate you as King.Over our lives. We invite you to once again take your throne over our lives. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.